got to just hear what a carillon sounds like, and we are so very blessed. Mike and Sandra have done a marvelous job of organizing this, selling ornaments. Did you see the ornaments when you came in? Those are all handmade by her. Christmas ornaments, fantastic. There's even one with Scrooge on it. And if I don't behave between now and Christmas, I may be getting one from Laura. I don't know. But please enjoy those. Purchase one. All the proceeds go towards a carillon. We got one already. All right. Rylan's, she's got one already. That's fantastic. But it'll really be excellent to be able to share that at the beginning of every service. And could you imagine people on the walking path hearing that music? It's going to be marvelous. So we hope and pray that by November 30th, the first Wednesday in Advent, we'll have enough money together to be able to purchase this. But I think, they're probably still in the narthex, aren't they? But just want to give them a round of applause, Mike and Sandra, for all they're doing. I think they've sold over $5,000 worth already, and they're just fantastic. So enjoy them and enjoy the carillon. And the word discombobulated, how, I don't even know how you spell it or how you say it exactly, but that's kind of how I feel right this second, because I was going into a Rally Sunday celebration at Celebration Hall, ready to talk about everything we got going on, and there was a birthday party and a kayak in there, so I'm kind of out of sorts just a little bit, but sincerely, thank you so very, very much. Really, really appreciate that. That's going to be so much fun. Julianne just happens to be a tomboy. She likes to fish already at 3 years of age, so getting her in that kayak and out in the water, that's going to be so much fun. So thank you very much. That's a surprise. First time in 20 years, really, I think I've been surprised here. So hats off. You did a great job on that. Thank you very, very much. When we talk about Rally Sunday, we always talk about getting involved in ministries, doing stuff, and thankfully, we have a lot going on. We start with men's Bible study Tuesday night. Wednesday, we have confirmation kids in Christ. We have women's Bible study in the morning and then in the evening as well. When we are humming, we have close to 100 people in Bible study every week, which is the way it should be. 30 teenagers downstairs in confirmation, kids in Christ. It's just, we are very, very blessed. And we invite you to participate and to share in all those. You will be blessed as you do so. We have a pizza dinner on Wednesday night. We invite choir members too to join with us for dinner. You're welcome to do that anytime. Pat, you want to share just a word about choir? Thank you very much, Pat. It's going to be a lot of fun. Always have fun in choir. They sing a little bit and laugh a lot and have a great time on Wednesday night. So join with us for choir on Wednesday if you can. Our theme today from Scriptures, and it's perfect for Rally Sunday, is hospitality and generosity. And how it ties in with Rally Sunday is this, and that is besides just getting involved in ministries, I think God wants us to get using the kayak and the fishing, to get involved in fishing, and that is to be welcoming, to be inviting. And we are the most welcoming congregation I know, but it's always one of those things we want to put out there all the time to remind ourselves to do that. Our three-year-old granddaughter had a choice between two schools. The preschool that she went to is the one where the teachers got up and out to the car and greeted her when she got in the parking lot and welcomed her all the way in. The other one, not so much. But she's loved it ever since, and they keep that going the whole time. So just one of those things to think about, that we are a welcoming congregation, and we need to continue that all the time as best we possibly can. A couple of notes on information for today. We've got lunch at Village Inn for our youth, and then right after that we're going to Hickory Cove. Beautiful day for that. Great day before school starts to enjoy all the amenities there, including kayaking, just saying. But and next weekend is the Tech Weekend. Appreciate your prayers and support. It's 12 of us going. I'll be with 11 teenagers, and, well, there'll be about 40 or 50 that'll be there. Always a blessed weekend. Can't wait for the drive home to hear what everybody has to say. So thank you for your support in that always. We lift up Hilda Yeager and also Sandy Rose, who are both in rehab, and Jean Pope and her family on the death of her daughter, Yolanda, just this morning. So Yolanda Rice. So we just lift up Jean and her family in prayers on that as well. So Wednesday night, join with us as we get started again. Guys, Tuesday night, and why don't we stand as we begin worship. Thank you. Sunday school teachers, if you would remain standing, though. We have a prayer for teachers. At Sunday school teachers, come on, everybody. And I know that Amy Daigle and Jamie Curtis have new responsibilities as principals, so double prayer. Isn't that right? Very, very proud of you and excited for you and excited for your students, quite frankly. Let's pray. Dear God, grant our teachers an abundance of your wisdom. Prepare their hearts to welcome and love their students. And may we show teachers love and respect in return. Give them grace as they help students who aren't thriving the courage to say what needs to be said tools and knowledge on how and when to speak love and strength when they feel weak. When they feel unseen, remind them that no moment goes unnoticed. They are shaping the future in incredible ways every single day. We are overwhelmed with gratitude for the gift of learning they share. Bless them, Lord, and may they see even just a glimpse of how their faithfulness will forever impact generations to come. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Let's give them a round of applause, huh? Thank you all. We have gifts for you. I'm going to have the kids at the children's servant hand those out to you. I can't wait to get them to you. They're really special. And would you mind, let's all stand. We've got to stand for this litany. Where is the church? The church of Jesus Christ is where a child of God brings a balloon. It's where young men see visions and old men dreams. The church of Jesus Christ is where the blind see and the deaf hear. It's where the lame run and the dying live. The church of Jesus Christ is where children lead and wise men follow. It's where mountains are moved and walls come tumbling down. The church of Jesus Christ is where loaves of bread are stacked in the sanctuary to feed the hungry. It's where shackles are discarded and kings and shepherds sit down to life together. The church of Jesus Christ is where the minister is ministered unto. Is where the anthem is the laughter of the congregation and the offering plates are full of people. The church of Jesus Christ is where people go when they skin their knees or their hearts. It's where judges don't judge and each child of God is beautiful and precious. The church of Jesus Christ is where the sea divides for the exiles. Is where the ark floats and the lamb lies down with the lion. The church of Jesus Christ is where night is day, is where lost lambs are found. The church of Jesus Christ is where people write thank you notes to God, is where seeds are scattered and miracles are grown. The church of Jesus Christ is where home is where a picnic is communion and people break bread together on their knees. The church of Jesus Christ is where we live responsively towards God's coming. Even on Thursday morning, the world will hear, Alleluia. Amen. You may be seated. It wouldn't be Rally Sunday without the skit guys, so.
Hey everybody, skit guys here. My name's Tommy and
my name's Eddie. How's it going, everybody?
Hey, Ms. Eddie, we just wanted to tell you it's back to school.
School time, everybody. Back to school time. Is everybody ready? Back to school.
Yep. I got my new backpack for back to school. And you've got
What I got is a hipster fanny pack right here. This is what all the cool kids are going to be doing, taking their stuff on their hip to school.
Buddy, that's a lunchbox.
No, it's not. Yeah. I got my pencils in here. My lunch money's right here. I haven't got a place for my hipster spoon.
Nope. That's a spoon because that's a lunchbox.
Oh, nay. Look. Oh, someone calling me? Hello? Bam, it's gone. Boom. Shutting my fanny pack, hipster lunch pail.
So, welcome back to school.
Welcome back to school, folks. It's going to be awesome. Completely awesome.
Yeah. Hey, if you have one of those, don't wear that. You're going to get beat up.
Cool kids.
Not cool.
All day long.
Not cool at all.
Hashtag all day long.
He's going to get beat up. Hashtag all day long.
Oh, my. All right. Time for the children's sermon. Kids, come on down. Bring your backpacks. We got some goodies for you. Oh, I can't wait to give this stuff to you. All right, Rylan, come on down. John. All right, Isaiah, how are you, buddy? Everybody good? Come on, honey. All right. Sophia's here. We got, look at this stuff. All right. Well, everybody ready for school? No? Okay, well, that's an honest answer. Here it comes anyway, huh? All right. come on down, buddy. We got all kind of good stuff for you. I've been looking forward to giving this to you. Also, what I'm going to have you do, you saw all the teachers stand up. I'm going to have you give them, after we're all done, after you got your candy and you got your gifts for your backpacks, I'm going to have you give each one of them one of these, okay? Is that cool? It says, together we inspire, engage, and encourage. And on the back it says, our school is a great place to be thanks to awesome people like you who keep student success in mind in everything they do. We could say our church, too, for our Sunday school teachers, couldn't we? But I'm going to have you take those out to everybody. Is that cool? It's always a good idea to give gifts to teachers. I remember doing that as a student all the time, sometimes out of necessity. But anyhow, we got some really, really neat stuff up here. Look at this. You see what this is? I'm going to let you each take one first, okay? All right, grab one of these, okay? Just, oh yeah, any color, would you? All right, Riley, can you get one back there? There you go, honey. There you go.
What is it?
I'm going to show you. Can you fit it on your finger? John's figured it out. All right, Isaiah. There you go, buddy. Ready? You already know what this is, don't you, Lawson? Huh? You can have another one, honey. He was my tester there in the office. We got to try out some of these gifts. Okay, guys, come on over here. How do you turn it off? That's a good question. All right, this is what you do. You got the ring on there. Before we do anything else, will somebody read the tag on there? Boy, you can tell I'm a grandpa, can't you? This is just so much fun. Can somebody read that tag? It says, yeah, go ahead. Do you want? All right, John, thank you. Awesome. Thank you, buddy. So Jesus is the light of the world. So sometimes if we feel like we're in darkness or just having a bad day, to remember that he's present with us, he loves us, and he's the light, you push the top like this. And what does it do? What does yours do? It lights up. Yeah, like that. Isn't that cool? All right. Isn't that neat? Yours said, here, get a new one then. Here you go. I had one that didn't work either. And you know how you turn it off? You press the top again. Yeah, like that. See, isn't that cool? Isn't that neat? I don't know. At first service, I kind of was having a little discussion. I'm not sure whether you should take these to school or not. As long as you know how to turn it off, it's probably okay. Or leave it in your backpack and show your friends. Your teachers may not pretty much like that. But anyhow, just fun to have, okay? All right. And just a reminder, and the top of it says, Jesus is the light. All right? Everybody have one? Okay. Anybody not like stickers, too? Stickers are fun. These are really cool. All right. Take one, pass one. There you go.
There you go. They're gold.
They're gold. They're all kind of different colors there. It's always fun if you've got a teacher that likes stickers. And I think all teachers like stickers. And you get a star, when you do a good job, isn't that right? On a paper or something like that, you get a star. Yeah, I remember back many, many years ago doing that, and it was kind of fun. But we get these because God wants us to know that in his eyes, we're all stars. Do you guys get those? That we're all stars, okay? We're all special in his eyes. It doesn't matter about grades and everything else. We try as hard as we can. Is everybody going to try as hard as they can, do the best that they can in school? Is that right? That's what my parents always said. Do the very best that you can always. And everything else will come together, and it's really true. You got one? Okay, but God gives us a star. And then I got one other thing for you. This is just like fun. And this says, star student. Okay, grab one. You guys are set to go. I hope you can fit something else in your backpack. There you go, honey.
Oh, this is going on my backpack.
That's going on? Well, that's a good place to put this. It's kind of like a necklace, but you can also just tie it on your backpack. It says star student. How cool is that, huh? Because each and every one of you are a star student. You get one? Oh my gosh, feels like Christmas up here, doesn't it? Okay, here you go, guys. You get one? All right. We're going to have a prayer together. I'm going to get you some candy just because, you know, I don't want to chip you. And then I'm going to have you take some these gifts out to teachers. Does that sound good? Okay. And I may have some extras, too. If you need to take one to your teacher later on in the year, let me know. Okay? All right? Let's have a prayer together. And you guys mind turning those rings off? There you go. We're good. Fantastic. Let's pray. Gracious Father, we thank you for this day. Lord, we just thank you for schools and classrooms and for the teachers and the students who fill them each day. We thank you for this new beginning, for new books and new ideas, for sharpened pencils and pointy crayons and crisp blank pages waiting to be filled. We thank you for the gifts of making mistakes and trying all over again. Help us to remember that asking the right questions is often as important as giving the right answers. Today we give you thanks for these young children. We ask that you would bless them. Let them know of your light in any darkness that they encounter. Let them know of your love and your presence always. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. All right, guys and gals, grab some candy here. And I bet you better save a hand or two for teachers. Teachers, would you stand up again? We've got something special for you. Thank you. These are really cool, too, by the way. All right, John, you want to take one? All right, that means principals, too, now, y'all. Stand up, if you would. They're going to come to you, and then you all can be seated, okay? Thank you, guys and gals. Good luck with school. We'll see you Wednesday night, okay? Here you go, sweetie. All right, you're good. Everybody get one, if you would. Lawson here, would you take one, honey? I think you know who to give this to. Okay. Teachers, remain standing. You want another one? Can you do it? Take one to your mom. There you go, honey. All right, buddy, you want to take one of these? Any of the teachers standing up? They're going to keep standing until you get them to them. All right, y'all? Okay, if you see the two in the back there. Here, I'll give you two. Is that all right? Thank you. Can we get the teachers taken care of? All right, y'all. Thank you. Teachers, thank you for all that you do. Kind of looks like my office up here.
Our first reading today comes from the book of Proverbs. Do not exalt yourself in the king's presence. Do not claim a place among his great men. It is better for him to say to you, "Come up here," than for him to humiliate you before his nobles. Here ends the first reading. Our second reading today comes from the book of Hebrews, chapter 13. Keep on loving one another as brothers and sisters. Do not forget to show hospitality to strangers, for by doing so, people have shown hospitality to angels without knowing it. Continue to remember those in prison as if you were with them in prison yourselves. Remember those people that's been mistreated as if yourself were suffering. Marriage should be honored by all, and the marriage bed kept pure, for God will judge the adulterer and sexual immorality. Keep your lives free from the love of money and be content with what you have, because God said, "Never will I leave you, never will I forsake you." So we say with confidence, "The Lord is my helper. I will not be afraid. What can mortals do to me?" Remember your leaders who spoke the word of God to you. Consider the outcome of their way of life and imitate their faith. Jesus Christ is the same yesterday and today and forever. Through Jesus, therefore, let us offer to God a sacrifice of praise, the fruit of our lips, and openly profess his name, and do not forget to do good and share with others, for with such sacrifices God is pleased. Here is the reading. Please stand for the Alleluia verse.
gospel reading can be found in the 14th chapter of Luke, beginning with the first verse. On one occasion, when Jesus was going to the house of a leader of the Pharisees to eat a meal on the Sabbath, they were watching him closely. When he noticed how the guests chose the places of honor, he told them a parable. When you are invited by someone to a wedding banquet, do not sit down at the place of honor in case someone more distinguished than you has been invited by your host. And the host who invited both of you may come and say to you, give this person your place. And then in disgrace, he would start to take the lowest place. But when you are invited, go and sit down at the lowest place so that when your host comes, he may say to you, friend, move up higher. Then you'll be honored in the presence of all who sit at the table with you. For all who exalt themselves will be humbled, and those who humble themselves will be exalted. And Jesus also said to the one who had invited him, when you give a luncheon or a dinner, do not invite your friends or your brothers or your relatives or rich neighbors, in case they invite you in return, and you should be repaid. But when you give a banquet, invite the poor, the crippled, the lame, and the blind. And you'll be blessed, because they cannot repay you, for you will be repaid at the resurrection of the righteous. The gospel of our Lord. You may be seated. I forgot to share in the announcement time, I talked about hospitality and generosity. And one of the things that Laura and I do, if we're here in town at all, and if we can, we set up coffee and goodies and all that kind of stuff as a way to say thank you to the Sunday school teachers, but also just because of generosity and hospitality. You walk in the narthex and you smell coffee. That means something to a Lutheran, that's for sure. In fact, that means so much that the senior group got this. It says, Pastor, fueled by coffee and the Holy Spirit. In that order. We understand that, I guess, yes? Someone has said before, if you want to teach the truth, tell it. If you want to love the truth, tell a story. I happen to believe that Jesus is the truth, and I want you to love him. And so I'm going to tell some stories. 37 years ago, Laura and I came to North Carolina, to Conover, North Carolina, to Mount Zion Lutheran Church for our internship. And we are driving around Conover, these 20-somethings, and we had a propensity towards getting lost then as much as we do now. Directionally challenged, I guess that's what you say. And we didn't have GPS then. So we're driving all over Conover. We're lost. And so by her insistence, we stopped to ask somebody for directions. And we drove up this long drive to this house, and we got out and talked with them. And, oh my goodness, they were fantastic. It's the best apple pie I've ever had in my life. We talked and we visited, and sure enough, they were members of Mount Zion Lutheran Church. And after a little while, I didn't even know why we came in the first place, you know what I mean? But generosity and hospitality has a way of doing that. You don't forget. It leaves an indelible mark for those who do that. Think with me for a moment of a time or somebody in your life that through generosity gave you a gift or time, some kind of resource that really touched your life. Or maybe through hospitality, a meal, or gave you a room to stay or time to stay, get life sorted out, whatever. You don't forget that, do you? I think of my dad. He was very hospitable. He loved to cook, and he would make these zucchini muffins, and Mom and Dad would take them out to shut-ins. He made pizza like nobody could make pizza. And he'd just keep on making it as long as we were eating it, even feeding a whole football team on occasion. And I think of Sherry Davis, and I think it's going to be 12 years this year that Sherry has been serving up Wednesday night meals and also working with us in the camps. And part of the reason I bring this up is she hasn't signed her contract yet for this year. Sherry, you good for this? Okay, well, good, good. But that's her love language, hospitality and generosity. And I'll never forget years ago, when we were in Florida, our large church in Florida had its own retreat center. We got to use that for a while. And we were down at the lake there at breakfast time with two of my buddies from that church. And the question was asked, would you like breakfast? And of course they said, no, we're fine. We're fine. That's not going to work. You know what I mean? So 2 seconds later, these two full plates of cream rice and cheese grits and eggs and bacon are in their laps. 5 minutes later, with no word spoken, it's all gone. And they're asking for seconds. They had never had Cherry's creamed rice before. Hospitality and generosity, these are things that when they happen, they leave an indelible mark. You just don't forget that. They happen to be hallmarks of what it means to be the people of God as well. And that means as a church, we're not just a house. It's not just a building with walls and a floor and a roof. That's a structure. It's a home. It's a home where lives are touched and changed and memories are made. And football is going on in the parking lot at 2 in the morning. And overnights, day and night, whether it's NA or Al-Anon or AA or Meals on Wheels, Boy Scouts, Girl Scouts, the lights are on, the parking lot's going on. It's a community center. And the message to the community is all are welcome, always. It's a powerful message. It's a message the world really needs to hear today. So about 5 years ago, we had a young lady visit at 8 o'clock service from Lenoir Rhyne University, Lenoir Rhyne College probably at that time. And she sat in the back at the 8 o'clock service, the very back pew, and she was weeping, literally sobbing, throughout the whole service. And our good people at Mount Pisgah went over to her and comforted her and said, is everything okay? Is everything all right? Of course, I met with her. Y'all, some of you remember this? I met with her during Sunday school in my office and talked and said, you know, how can we help? What was it that so deeply moved you? Was it the sermon? You know her answer, I guess, do you? And she said, no, it wasn't the sermon. I said, well, what was it? She said, it was your sign, our church sign. We didn't have the electronic sign then. We had that canvas flapping in the wind, you know? And it had an unflappable message on it. All are welcome. Isn't that cool? She said, you really mean that? I said, yeah, my boss, our Lord, kind of, that's important to him. Everybody's welcome. Yeah, we try to do that. Everybody is welcome. Everybody? Yes. She said, you don't understand. I said, maybe I don't. But she said, that means a lot to really, really hear that. Let that sink in. Do you believe that Jesus was that way on this earth and he is today and he wants us as the people of God to always be welcoming? You know, the reason we are generous and hospitable is because he is first generous and hospitable. He invites us, if you listen carefully to that gospel, not just to invite our friends and family to a meal, but what does he say? To invite the crippled, the blind, the lame, people that we might not associate with at all, to come to our house, to our home, to our church, to be welcomed by him. That's the kind of Lord we have. There are no boundaries, open to absolutely everybody. When we were in Amsterdam, we did a lot of walking around different places, lots of walking. And one of the places that we went, it was during the day, but we had to walk through this place to get to another place. We walked through a certain district in Amsterdam. You've probably heard about it before, the red light district. And, you know, of course, we're giggling and covering our eyes and walking through quickly and everything else and got to the other side. That night, I remember getting with everybody. I said, you know, we really beat feet through there and, you know, because of what it means and what it stands for. But you know something? Listen, we have a Lord who spent time there. He stopped there. He made friends there. He got to know the names of the women there. He loved on them and accepted them and welcomed them. He had dinner with prostitutes and tax collectors. Oh my goodness, really? Why? To let us know that there are no boundaries, there are no lines drawn in the sand, that all are welcome in His grace and in His love. We need to hear that over and over again, that we are forgiven. There's nothing we have done or will do that He won't love us and accept us. And you know, one of the main reasons why He went to the cross is because He was so welcoming. Think about that. And the only reason I can make any sense out of this meal that we're invited to called Holy Communion is that all of us are welcome, but none of us, not one of us, are worthy to come to this table of grace. And He not only invites us to come, but He gives us Himself. Talk about hospitality. Talk about generosity. My body given for you. My blood shed for you. Broken and given for us. There is a hymn in the scriptures in Philippians. We don't know how they sang this hymn in service, but we know what the words are. And the words are simply this: have this mind among yourselves that was in Christ Jesus, that though He was equal with God, did not count equality with God a thing to be grasped, but emptied Himself and took the form of a servant, even obedient unto death itself on a cross. The ultimate symbol of generosity and hospitality. Also in that same scripture, it says, at the end of time, when our Lord comes back, every knee will bow and every tongue will confess that Jesus Christ is Lord. Every knee will bow, will be bent, I believe, because we're going to be so amazed at His love. As the Lamb who was slain comes back to bring us all home, it's going to be a marvelous thing. Think of this. The prodigal who comes home to his welcoming, generous, loving father. He's probably on a bended knee, don't you think? And so are we, on bended knee before our Lord, before His generous hospitality and love. And He invites us each and every day to experience that as if for the very first time and to share it with others.
Are you running around in circles with no place to go? Is there a person in the mirror you don't even know? Someone still sees who you are. Yeah. Were you the kid who was a dreamer? Now you don't believe. Are you the lock that got so broken? Now you lost the key. Someone still loves who you are. Yeah. To everyone who ever lost your way, to everyone who ever felt ashamed, here's a song for all the broken hearted. I believe you're only getting started. To anyone who trusts in Jesus' name, watch your world become forever changed. Here's a song about light from darkness. I believe you're only getting started. Treasure that you really are. If you could understand the measure of the Father's heart. He loves you, He loves you, He loves you. Fall in His arms and let Him wash you clean. He'll tear off the chains so that you can be free. The new life begins in the to anyone who ever lost you.
to everyone who ever felt ashamed. Here's a song for all the brokenhearted. I believe you're only getting started. To anyone who trusts in Jesus' name, watch your world become forever changed. Here's a song about light from darkness. I believe you're only getting started.
Would you please stand as we share the affirmation of faith? We believe in God, the Lord Almighty, creator of heaven and the earth. He is our God, and we are his people, the works of his hands and the treasure of his heart. We believe in Jesus Christ, God's only Son, who was born of a virgin, died on the cross for the forgiveness of our sins, and rose from the dead. He ascended into heaven, where he rules with the Father in all power. Jesus is our Redeemer, and we are the sheep of his pasture, receivers of his abundant grace. We believe in the Holy Spirit, the giver of life, and the power of God at work in us and in the church today. Day after day, the Spirit guides us and keeps us strong in the truth. This we believe and confess with our whole heart, soul, and mind. For this is most certainly true. May be seated. The night in which he was betrayed, our Lord Jesus took bread, gave thanks, and broke it, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take and eat. This is my body given for you. Do this in remembrance of me." Again after supper, he took the cup, gave thanks, and gave it for all to drink, saying, "This cup is a new covenant in my blood, shed for you and for all people for the forgiveness of sin. Do this in remembrance of me." Lord, remember us in your kingdom and teach us to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever and ever. Amen. Body of Christ given for you. Body of Christ given for you. David, the body of Christ given for you. Blood of Christ shed for you. Blood of Christ shed for you. Blood of Christ shed for you. Amen.
This is the air I breathe. This is the air I breathe. Your holy presence living in me. This is my day. Bread. This is my daily bread. Your very word spoken to me, and for you and
And I invitation to please stand. Now may the body and blood of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ strengthen us and keep us in his grace. And may the Lord bless us and keep us. May the Lord make his face shine upon us and be gracious unto us. May the Lord look upon us with favor and give us his peace. Amen. Amen.
Forgiven because you were forsaken. I'm accepted, you were condemned. I'm alive and well, your spirit is within me because you died and rose again. Amazing love. You, my King, would die for me. Amazing love, I know it's true. Now it's my joy to honor you in all I do. I honor you. I'm forgiven. Because you were forsaken, I'm accepted, you were condemned. I'm alive and well, your spirit is within me, because you died and rose again. Amazing love, how can it be? That you, my King, would die for me. Amazing love, I know it's true. Now it's my joy to honor you in all I do. I honor you. You
surprise. Go in peace, serve the Lord. Thanks be to God.